Hey, thanks again for checking out You Chapter 2. I got a really good one for you guys today. Stick with me. As you know, I like to show what's possible with Bluebeam, and today's not going to be any different. I've got a tool called Quantity Link, which I know you've seen videos of before and things like that, but I really want to show you some powerful things that we can do that are being overlooked in the industry with Quantity Link. So first off, I can't emphasize enough how important custom tools are. I've got a couple of examples here. Today, I'm going to go through my concrete slabs and show you how I've got those built into my quantity link. So right off the bat, I notice here it says a 6-inch slab on grade. So I'm going to go to my 6-inch slab tool over here, and I'm going to go ahead and just trace in this area down to my slab line, and you'll notice as soon as I let go, it's putting that quantity over into my spreadsheet. I have those linked. Down here it says 5-inch slab or slab on grade, so I'm going to draw in this area, and you'll see over in the spreadsheet those quantities are going to update. You'll also see this fun little graph. I just wanted to show the percentage of the concrete that's piers, slabs, and isolated footings just for fun. You'll see that go and update as well live while we're putting in our markups. So let's say we've got some welded wire fabric. Let's do that 5-inch slab here with welded wire fabric. I'm going to come in and trace down to my concrete line again. Looks a little bit different, and it also adds my welded wire fabric square footage in there. I'm going to do the same thing with the 6-inch here. You'll see that quantity come up again. The quantity of concrete moved up as well. So, what I wanted to emphasize today was not just the custom tools and being able to point to those in Excel, but you can see here, once we get into Excel, everything's just a formula. And this is all kind of the backstory here is that I wrote an article for Bluebeam on their website, and you can check that one out. I'll put the link in the notes and also a blog post that I wrote on my website at You Chapter 2, talking about how to set these up. So you can walk through those steps and learn how to set these up. And then there's another article in there on the advanced workflows and all. So some of that's going to be shown here in a second. So once we get into Excel, we have the power of all these formulas. So this is the total for the concrete isolated footings and piers and slabs. And then I can have those all add up, obviously. But what's fun is if I have, let's say, a standard truck that is 11, that would be 11 yards, cubic yards. So it would be 12.3 trucks. So they're going to bring out 13 trucks. But if I change this over to a front end, a front load, it's going to be 9.5 yards per truck. And now it's telling me I need 14, maybe 15 trucks on that delivery. Also, I can update my pricing. So if the price changes tomorrow and all of a sudden this is $300 a yard, swap that out, updates all of my pricing over here. And that's my total for concrete, and it's coming in here with my totals, including the welded wire fabric. Welded wire fabric, with this square footage, it's telling me that I need 25 sheets that are 4 by 10. I believe I worked in some overlap in there as well. That would be normal. And then pricing it at $25 per sheet, it's telling me I need $623.38 for my welded wire fabric. Another fun one, way off over to the side over here, is our forms. So this number is coming in, and it is basically giving us the length of the perimeter of each of those slabs. So it's telling us that we need 660 feet of, I don't know, 2x8s. If you get them in 12-foot sections, add that in here, and it'll tell you the number of 2x8s you need to buy for your forms. Okay? So that's one of the examples I want to show you. The other one, real quick, I'm going to open up another Excel file here. This is my exterior wall example that I kind of spelled out in my blog post. Again, I'll put the link to that in my notes down or in my description down below the video. But in here, we're going to go to a different tool set, my wood walls, and I'm just going to grab onto my exterior walls, and I'm just going to draw in a rough line here. Double click there. It's going to label it exterior wood wall. And notice here, it brought in the length of that wall. The rest of this is all formulas, okay? We need that linear footage of baseboards or base plate. So it's a treated 2x6 by 12 foot are the ones I'm buying. They're $10.96 a piece. I need four of them, and that's giving me the price. I need to double that for my double top plate. I have studs at 16 inches on center, anchor bolts at 48 inches on center, bundles of batted insulation, exterior sheathing, and interior sheetrock is all being calculated off the length of that wall. So again, if I draw another wall in here, double click to finish it, it's going to update that quantity. It's going to update all of this information as well and give me new totals for my exterior wall. So you don't have to come up with custom tools for every one of these little elements or materials in your building. You can do one line for one tool and build out these assemblies for everything that's part of that wall. Everything's a formula. So again, just kind of excited about this one. I want to get it out there. I've been wanting to do this video for about 4 years. I hope you guys like it. Jump in the Brainery and let me know what you think. If you want to see anything else, let me know that as well. Thanks for checking it out.